Hi guys. Okay, today it's a very interesting update for you. Actually, as you can see, I'll give you a generic update on Samsung Galaxy S5. Yeah, it's S5. Actually, it's not yet released in India, so it's a product that we have got on online through pre-booking actually. So as you can see, I've given a very beautiful case cover, a magnetic case cover to it. The phone looks really great like this. Okay, if I open the phone and you will find the interface. Yeah, here it is. As you can see, this is the most latest entry by Samsung Galaxy, known as S5. It has a 5.1 inch screen display. Let me show you the display. Yep. As you can see, it's a pretty big display over here. So it's a 5.1 inch display diagonally if you see, and you can see it's very bright. Like Samsung, they always has a great display, so it's giving a great light. As you can see, it give a great feeling to the phone. Okay, here it is. As you can see, the interface, and of course it comes with KitKat, Android KitKat, that is Android 4.4, the latest OS in offering. So the most important noteworthy change in KitKat that you will see is the notification panel. If I slide it down, as you can see that, yeah, in KitKat they have done some really great things with this S5 and the KitKat combination. It's a dual SIM variation. As you can see, I have used two SIM, SIM 1 and SIM 2. It's a dual SIM variation. You can easily adjust the brightness, contrast, everything, stuff like that. And in the upper portion, there is a Wi-Fi, the mobile data, the screen rotation, the sounds, location, everything. What they have done is actually they have given a pretty good display over here according to the UI. So users can get to see it and get a good feeling of the phone. Okay, now as you can see that here is some rectangular boxes. If I just tap on them, you can see you can easily toggle through, navigate through the internet, the camera, the microphone, the calculator, stuff like that. So it has made actually very easy for users to use the phone also. So now if I go to settings over here, here you will see the another thing that here what KitKat has done. They have given a very beautiful display over here also. Now just to be sure that this particular device is an S5 Lite. Over here you can see the model number, that says SMG900FD. If you Google it, you will find that it's an S5 model with a dual SIM variation and the Android version. As it says, it's Android 4.4.2. It's KitKat. See, it comes, the logo of KitKat comes like that. Okay. whatever it is. Now as per the specification of the phone, what it has is a very eye-catching or noteworthy. As you can see, it's a big camera. Actually, it's a 16 megapixel camera. 16, yeah, it is a 16 megapixel camera at the rear with LED flash, and of course the front camera is a 2 megapixel one. Just let me show you how the camera works, actually how it looks. Okay, now the rear camera, if I go over here and I just get a focus area just like that and just give it some time, as you can see, yeah, it will take some time to get accustomed to the background and take the picture. If I go to the picture over here, over there, and let you show the quality, yeah, now let me zoom in. Yeah, you will see that actually it's pretty good. It's a pretty big deep zoom over here also. So it's pretty worth the money for a 16 megapixel camera. And as you know, the what Samsung always does is that their flash is actually very good, and one of the best flash that they have actually. And now if I give you a view of the front camera, like it's a just display message, as you can see, the front camera, it's pretty good. If you can see, just as that, I'm just showing you the display of this particular thing. It's a 2 megapixel front camera, so of course it has its worth. It's money's worth actually. Okay, now let's get back to the main screen. Right. The Samsung Galaxy S5 comes with a 2800 mAh battery, that is 2800 mAh battery, and it gives you a standby of 390 hours and a talk time standby of 21 hours. So that's pretty decent actually, considering Samsung's problem with battery, but it's a decent battery, as I can say. Also, it comes with the different color variations, like a black, gold, blue and blue white. I have gone for the black one. It's end of the day, it's your choice, whatever you choose. But yeah, it's a very good phone. Okay, now let us come to the most important specifications, like the processors and the RAM. What Samsung has done with S5 is that they have given a Qualcomm Snapdragon 8 O1 chipset motherboard. Actually, it's a very much latest entry by Qualcomm Snapdragon, because the latest one that they used to manufacture was a Qualcomm Snapdragon 400 motherboard, but now in this particular phone they have used Qualcomm Snapdragon 801, that is 801 chips motherboard actually. And along with that, they use the processor that they have used is a quad core 2.5 gigahertz Crate 400 processor. So what it does is that it gives you a pretty unique feeling in terms of speed. If you just check it, or if you just install a pretty high-end game, actually you will see for yourself that the performance will enhance. And most importantly, since Android stores its memory in stores some portion or runs the app in the background as well as in the physical memory, that is a RAM, they have given a 2GB RAM also. So the you just imagine the combination of a Qualcomm Snapdragon 801 motherboard with a 2GB RAM and of course a quad-core 2.5 gigahertz processor. So that's a deadly combination, a deadly combo actually, worth the money actually. So that is the reason it's a high-end phone by Samsung also. And now what it does is that this particular phone comes with a 16GB internal memory variation as well as a 32GB internal memory variation. This particular phone that I'm holding over here is a 16GB memory variation. So apart from that, it has an extended, it is extendable up to 128GB. Yeah, you have heard it right. So by it's extendable up to 128 and an inbuilt of 16GB. It's pretty high memory. So you can use it, store apps, use the particular phones, just play with it, install whatever it is. And most importantly, in the glass corner they have used Gorilla Glass 3 actually. It's the latest technology in terms of the screens and all, glasses and all. So it's a Gorilla Glass 3, so actually it's a very good combination. It's actually scratch proof, although I used a screen protector over here just for my sake actually. But whatever it is, it's actually end of the day it's a pretty high-end phone. It has some good features, good hardware parts, inbuilt stores memories, each and every aspect. It's a thumbs up actually. And what I'll suggest is that you can, if you are planning to buy, you can easily go for it, get the phone, use it as per your end. That's it guys. Maybe I'll install some more, maybe I'll install some high-end games in it, and I'll just show you how it runs actually, this deadly combination of the processor, the RAMs and stuff like that. Anyway, yeah, the so that's it for now. Please like my video, subscribe to my YouTube channel. I'll give you more interesting updates in the days to come. Thank you. Bye-bye.